Hello subscribers, here is another opinions video, and this time I'll be doing my opinions on the new 2019 CollectA dinosaur figures. I'll be doing my opinions on the ones that were revealed over the past 2 weeks. First up we have the Supreme Range Kaiua Jara figure. Now this figure looks really nice. The pose, it's in a standing pose, and I really like pterosaurs in standing poses. And the crest looks awesome, especially with those awesome colors. But I probably won't be getting it because, you know, collective figures, especially the Supreme and Deluxe ones, are expensive. That's why I have, very few collective figures in my collection. I only buy the ones I really want. But this figure still looks amazing, but of course, I'll skip on it, like I said. Next up, we have a Boreal Opelta. And this figure just looks amazing. And I might end up getting it, because it's a standard size figure, and it shouldn't cost too much. And why not have a figure of the most well-preserved dinosaur? See, the detailing and the paint job looks great. And this is the second Nodosaur we'll be getting for 2019, the first one being Shlykes and the Mantarx. And those two figures will look great next to each other. So yes, I might pick this figure up. Next up, we have a Prehistoric Mammals Tube. And I'm not really excited for this set because, like CollectA's first two dinosaur tubes, these are just, smaller versions of the, previously made larger figures. The Prehistoric Marine Life set was probably CollectA's best tube because the majority of figures in that set were completely new species and new sculpts. But as you can see here, we have a Moropus, a Dinotherium, a Woolly Mammoth, a Paraceratherium, a Kalenkin, a Euintatherium, an Estaminosuchus, a Deodon, an Androsarcus, an Arsenotherium, a Smilodon, and a Megaceratops. And it's kind of strange that there's an Estaminosuchus in here, because all these creatures here are, Cenozoic mammals, and Estaminosuchus is a Paleozoic mammal-like reptile. Yeah, overall, like I said, not really excited for this set, but it's still somewhat cool. Next up, we have this awesome-looking Adapasaurus. And finally, we have an Adapasaurus figure. A good Adapasaurus figure. And see, the detailing on here is pretty nice, and this awesome paint job. The greens and the browns is somewhat similar to the Estaminosuchus from last year. And I really like how they added the pink-purplish color on the sail. And this figure will look great next to their 2018 Dimetrodon. And I think this is a deluxe figure. And it'll be pretty pricey, but hopefully I can get my hands on it. It depends on, the price. Here's the last figure for part one of this opinions video, which is CollectA's new Carnotaurus. Now, when I first saw this figure, I wasn't too impressed with it. I don't know why, but the more that I look at it, the more it starts to grow on me. I really like this figure now. I think it's actually better than Safari's 2019 Carnotaurus. Because Safari's Carno, like, the paint job I'm not really a huge fan of, while the pose is better than this Carnotaur right here, the face on the Safari Carno, it didn't really look intimidating, and it looked, kind of goofy. This one actually looks ferocious, and the color scheme on this collected Carno is a lot better. And yes, I'll be certainly getting this figure, and it's a deluxe figure, so it'll probably be, quite pricey. But hopefully I'll have enough money to buy this figure. So that is it for part 1 of this CollectA 2019 Dinosaur Figure Opinions video. Stay tuned for part 2 coming next week. So if you like this video, leave a comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.